We are now joined by Bangsamoro Government Chief Minister Ahod Balawag Ebrahim. Good afternoon, sir, and thank you so much for taking our call.
Good afternoon, Paul. Good afternoon to our viewers.
Mm-hmm. Chief Minister, the President has signed into law this controversial bill that was rallied against by so many people, most especially congressmen hailing from Mindanao, where various terror attacks have taken place. Now, the palace has spoken on the matter, saying these concerns are unfounded. Hadiraki even saying there may have been prejudgment on the law, sir. Would you agree on their statement?
Yeah, actually, last June 22, I issued a statement, official statement, in behalf of the Bangsamoro Autonomous Region Muslim Mindanao as interim chief minister, appealing to the president for a further review of the some provisions of the anti-terrorism bill. Mm-hmm. Particularly yung issue of the defining the terrorists, mm-hmm. terrorism, mm-hmm. and then the surveillance of suspect, and three, the power of the Anti-Terrorism Council to order the arrest. Mm-hmm. These are the three main concern. It is because you know, we are at the center of the terrorist attack in Mindanao, mm-hmm. and our people feel very concerned, and we have experience namin during those days ay nagbibigay ng parang concern ng ating mga constituent. Kaya yun ang dahilan nung kami nag-issue ng statement. Mm-hmm. And then itong statement namin ay kasi yung gobyerno namin is a parliamentary form of government, so I passed it to the parliament, and nagkaroon sila ng resolution. Itong resolution nila, just last July 2, resolution number 77, respectfully appealing to His Excellency President Rodrigo Duterte to veto Senate Bill number mm-hmm. 1083 mm-hmm. and House Bill number 6873, or the Anti-Terrorism Act of 2020, in order to provide Congress the opportunity to review and address the issues of vagueness, overbreath, and other concerns. Mm-hmm. So ito yung inisyu namin, and we passed it to the office of the president. Mm-hmm. But then, actually nga, kahapon, we were informed that the president have already signed the law, the anti-terrorist bill. So kanina, we have issued also another statement. Itong statement namin mm-hmm. is a statement on the signing of the Anti-Terrorism Act of 2020. Mm-hmm. On 3 July 2020, President Rodrigo Duterte signed the Anti-Terrorist Act of 2020 into law. The Bangsamoro Autonomous Region in Muslim Mindanao, bar being a government itself, will fully respect the decision of the president. Mm-hmm. There is no one way of addressing threats of terrorism, which is an evolving discourse globally. The bar is open to engage the national government on preparedness against the vicious phenomenon, as we collectively explore new potential approaches to holistically protect our people from the menace of terrorism. This engagement can start with the Bangsamoro having representation in the Anti-Terrorism Council. The leadership of the Bangsamoro government is cognizant of the need for a strong policy direction on the fight against terrorism. We trust that the President will ensure that the concerns and apprehensions of the Bangsamoro people on some provisions of the law will not happen. Rest assured that we will support the implementation of the law and commit to continue the conversation within the Bangsamoro in our efforts to provide the national government realistic context from the ground. So ito po yung statement namin na initial kami kanina kanina umaga pala.
Okay, now, sir, thank you for that, for the statement that you just mentioned. Now, the palace has spoken about this, saying that you can issue as many resolutions, as many statements as you want. Now, one of the bill's principal sponsors, Senator Panfilo Lacson, before the bill has been signed into a law, has offered to brief BARMM officials on the intent and nature of the Anti-Terrorism Act. He says he would be doing this to ease your concerns. Sir, would you be taking him up on this offer or at least open lines for discourse?
Yes, for the as far as we are concerned in the bar, we are open for a dialogue in order to really we really need to express also yung concern ng aming mga constituent and ensure that ito ay hindi mangyayari dahil hindi yun ang kinatatakot nila, because before the during the height of the war here in Mindanao, conflict in Mindanao, marami sa aming mga constituent ang naka-experience ng iba-ibang human rights violation, saka mga maraming mga tao na just disappeared, na hindi alam kung saan napunta. So this is what we are, so we are open for engagement.
That's good, sir. Secretary Hari Roque actually said that this piece of legislation is against terrorists and not is against terrorism and terrorists. Now, you mentioned earlier that you are a little worried on the vague terminologies in the law. Let's take, for example, the word terrorist. Now, I would want to know, sir, individuals can be easily tagged as such as terrorists. Now, there are some members of Muslim communities who have also voiced their concerns on this, stemming from a history of abuse from authority. Do you think their fears and concerns are warranted? And can you also cite some examples of this kind of abuse, sir?
Now, we really believe that the intention of the bill is really in good faith, because it is really in order to suppress itong terrorism na nangyayari dito sa ating bansa. However, yun ang concern natin, na if there will be an abuse from the authority on some provisions, meron nasisilip yung mga constituent namin na posibleng i-abuse, ma-abuse ito, and then that would be an opening for exploitation by some people. Pero kung ito naman ay ma-ensure natin na there will be no abuse in the implementation, sa aming panig naman eh, suportado kami sa bill na ito, because it will really strengthen our fight against terrorism. So kaya nga, isang parang opinion namin ngayon na gusto namin kumari na yung bar magkaroon ng magkasama doon sa council, maging membro ng council, can represent our, para at least makatulong na hindi ma-abuse yung authority implementation.
Sir, you mentioned earlier that you're saying now that you're not in total disagreement over the law, right? But you mentioned earlier that you would want some further review on some provisions, most particularly, let's take for example, the ATC holding too much power and being able to do warrantless arrests, so detention without judicial warrant. How would you think, sir, this will affect people, especially in the Muslim region, against unreasonable arrest? Do you believe that the law has enough safeguards?
Well, I was listening to the interview in some network kanina kay Senator Pampilo Lacson. And he was explaining about the safety measures na inilagay nila dito sa bill. So at least on my side, nakikita ko na as long as there will be a yung implementation lang talaga ang fund na hindi ma-abuse, I'm confident na maiwasan naman natin ito, yung mga concern ng kasi tama naman yung concern na kasi yung kung hindi masyadong clear yung pag how to define what is terrorist, there will be vagueness in the process of defining it. You can just easily pick anybody and declare here as a terrorist, and then the council also, if they will abuse their powers, then they can also detain anybody at any time they want. So yun ang ayaw natin na mangyari.
Of course, sir, everybody's been saying that this law is prone to abuse. That is what we are trying to prevent from happening. But this is granting sweeping power to the ATC with, we can even say that it's almost autonomous in nature, and it has no separate body to challenge their decisions before they are to be carried out. Sir, do you think there should be another safeguard measure that is ought to be set up to hold them within their proper limits?
Well, as explained by the sponsors of the bill, na yung daw warrantless arrest, there is a limit to that. Na the it has to be hindi naman pwedeng one. I think they say that they have put a safety measure in order na hindi ito ma-abuse. Kailangan na because it will also necessitate the action of the judicial plans of the government.
All right, with that, sir, I will let you go. Thank you so much, Chief Minister of the Bangsamoro Autonomous Region in Muslim Mindanao, Mr. Ahod Balawag Ibrahim, for your time, sir, and do take care.
Thank you very much, and thank you for this opportunity. And I would like to reiterate our appeal to the national government and the president that we hope that this bill will be implemented and will not be abused by the authorities.
All right.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir, and good afternoon.